You are listening to South Dakota Public Broadcasting's live webcast service on the South Dakota Network. More information at sd.net. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Links to live events and their archives are available at sd.net. Thank you. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Follow us on Twitter at SDNet for announcements about what's coming up. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Download the SDNet app to your mobile device and listen wherever you are. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Links to live events and their archives are available at sd.net. You are listening to South Dakota Public Broadcasting's live webcast service on the South Dakota Network. More information at sd.net. Thank you. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Links to live events and their archives are available at sd.net. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Follow us on Twitter at SDNet for announcements about what's coming up. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Download the SDNet app to your mobile device and listen wherever you are. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Links to live events and their archives are available at sd.net. Thank you. You are listening to South Dakota Public Broadcasting's live webcast service on the South Dakota Network. More information at sd.net. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Links to live events and their archives are available at sd.net. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Follow us on Twitter at SDNet for announcements about what's coming up. Thank you for listening to the South Dakota Network, a service of SDPB. Download the SDNet app to your mobile device and listen wherever you are. Thank you.
Joint Appropriations will come out of recess and we'll continue with our agenda. We are going to move to House Bill 1030, which is to make an appropriation for the revised construction costs of the bioproducts facility in Brookings and to declare an emergency. We've had the testimony, we had the question. The bill is now open for discussion and or action by the committee.
Madam Chair.
Representative Van Huysen.
I would move to pass.
It's been moved by Representative Van Huysen, seconded by Representative Ott, and do pass on House Bill 1030. Any comments on that motion?
Madam Chair.
Go ahead.
This is a construction project that was authorized by a prior legislature. It's funded with state general funds as well as some private donations. It has it is in progress and actually well down the line of being complete and has cost overruns that are very real, and so I would ask for your support.
Thank you. Any further comments on that motion? If not, the motion before the committee on House Bill 1030 is due pass. Those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye. Those opposed, nay. Secretary will call the roll.
Representative Otten.
Aye.
Representative Kasson.
Aye.
Representative Mills.
Nay.
Senator Wick.
Aye.
Representative Duba.
Aye.
Senator Foster.
Aye.
Senator Johnson.
Excuse.
Representative Kroll.
Aye.
Senator Maher.
No.
Representative Carr.
No.
Representative Koth.
Aye.
Senator Kolbeck.
Aye.
Senator Boland.
Aye.
Senator Wink.
Aye.
Senator Van Huysen.
Representative Van Huysen votes aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Aye. Senator Breitling.
Aye.
Representative Derby.
Aye.
Senator Hunoff.
Aye.
14 yay, 3 nay, 1 excused.
By majority vote of this committee, House Bill 1030 is passed. With that, we will move to House Bill 1031, make an appropriation for the revised construction costs of the Dairy Research and Extension Farm at South Dakota State University and to declare an emergency. We have the public hearing, the questions. We're at the point where discussion or action by the committee.
Madam Chair.
Senator Maher.
I move that we table House Bill 1031.
Second.
It's been moved by Senator Maher, seconded by Senator Boland to table House Bill 1031. That's a non-debatable motion. Those in favor of the motion to table signify by saying aye. Those opposed, nay. Secretary will call the roll.
Representative Kasson.
Aye.
Representative Mills.
Aye.
Senator Wick.
No.
Representative Duba.
Aye.
Senator Foster.
Aye.
Senator Johnson.
Aye.
Representative Kroll.
Aye.
Senator Maher.
Aye.
Representative Carr.
Aye.
Representative Koth.
Aye.
Senator Kolbeck.
Aye.
Senator Boland.
Aye.
Senator Wink.
Aye.
Representative Van Huysen.
Aye.
Senator Breitling.
Aye.
Representative Derby.
Aye.
Senator Hunoff.
Aye.
17 aye, 1 nay.
House Bill 1031 has been tabled. Okay, move on. House Bill 1032, make an appropriation for the demolition and reconstruction of agricultural use structures at South Dakota State University and to declare an emergency. Again, the public hearing, the questions. At this time, the committee is for discussion and or action.
Madam Chair.
Representative Van Huysen.
I move to pass.
Second.
Representative Van Huysen moves due pass on House Bill 1032, seconded by Senator Breitling. Comments on that motion?
This bill is other fund expenditures authority from insurance proceeds and institutional funds and federal funds. I'd ask for your support.
Thank you. Any other comments?
Senator, for the record, to make sure that there are no HEF dollars being utilized here.
I'm going to have to ask the question for the Board of Regents person.
Madam Chair.
Go ahead.
Heather Forney, Vice President for Finance and Administration for the Board of Regents. Thank you for making my trip over here worthwhile, Senator Maher. There are no HEF dollars in this project.
Thank you. All right. With that, the motion before the group is do pass on House Bill 1032. Those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye. Those opposed, nay. Secretary will call the roll.
Representative Otten.
Aye.
Representative Kasson.
Aye.
Representative Mills.
Aye.
Senator Wick.
Aye.
Representative Duba.
Aye.
Senator Foster.
Aye.
Senator Johnson.
Aye.
Representative Kroll.
Aye.
Senator Maher.
Aye.
Representative Carr.
Aye.
Representative Koth.
Aye.
Senator Kolbeck.
Aye.
Senator Boland.
Aye.
Senator Wink.
Aye.
Representative Van Huysen.
Aye.
Senator Breitling.
Aye.
Representative Derby.
Aye.
Senator Hunoff.
Aye.
18 yeas, 0 nay.
By unanimous vote of the committee, House Bill 1032 is passed. Now move to Senate Bill 18 to revise the appropriation for a livestock and equestrian complex at the state fair and to declare an emergency. Again, the public hearing was held, testimony was taken, questions were answered. We are moving into the discussion and or action item.
Madam Chair.
Senator Breitling.
Madam Chair, I move do pass on Senate Bill 18.
Second.
It's been moved by Senator Breitling, seconded by Senator Boland to approve Senate Bill 18. Comments on that motion?
This is a good complex for the state fairgrounds. It's under construction now. It'll be finished with this construction inflation. Appreciate your support on this bill.
Thank you. Any other comments? Hearing none. Those in favor of the motion of due pass on Senate Bill 18 signify by saying aye. Those opposed, nay. Secretary will call the roll.
Representative Otten.
Aye.
Representative Kasson.
Aye.
Representative Mills.
Nay.
Senator Wick.
Aye.
Representative Duba.
Nay.
Senator Foster. Senator Johnson.
Aye.
Representative Kroll.
Aye.
Senator Maher.
No.
Representative Carr.
Nay.
Representative Koth.
Aye.
Senator Kolbeck.
Aye.
Senator Boland.
Aye.
Senator Wink.
Aye.
Representative Van Huysen.
Aye.
Senator Breitling.
Aye.
Representative Derby.
Aye.
Senator Hunoff.
Aye.
12 yea, 6 nay.
By majority vote of this committee, Senate Bill 18 is passed. Okay, now we're going to do Senate Bill 172, which increases the appropriation for the construction costs related to the Health Services Center at Black Hills State University, Rapid City, and to declare an emergency. I'm going to go a little bit rogue here. We had the public testimony in the hearing. There is an amendment that at this point has not been moved, but I believe there needs to be some discussion on that. So I would look for the sponsor of that amendment. You can do what, if you want to talk about it, then somebody, if you want to talk about it, then somebody else.
So we do have an amendment, Amendment 172A. What it does is it changes the appropriation from $5 million in construction inflation to $1 million in design costs. We've since learned that the design costs will be higher than $1.5 million, than $1 million. It'll be up to close to $1.5 at both of these two sites. And so we have a conversation about if the amendment makes sense right now or if it doesn't make sense. And so that's why we're struggling. Again, we've got dollars available for the $5 million at both these two sister facilities. Wanted to open that up for discussion here.
I'm going to take the privilege here. Board of Regents. Rep, did you want to address this just so the committee has the understanding of where the concern is coming from?
Madam Chair, members of the committee, Heather Forney, Vice President for Finance and Administration for the Board of Regents again. So to the amendment with the $1 million for planning and architect and engineering fees, we've kind of gone through line item by line item on each of the West River Health Science Facility and the Northern Lincoln Hall facilities. And in both of those instances, we're closer to $1.5 million just for planning. So to give you some context, for Northern, it would be about $298,000 for schematic design, $398,000 for design development, $796,000 for the construction documents, and then they've got some additional fees for OSE and the cost of testing soils on those locations. And the same, very similar for BH Rapid City, about $1.4 million for the architect and engineering fees, again, in kind of those schematic construction design phases, and then $50,000 for OSE and $15,000 for testing. And to give you some maybe background, I think maybe it was Representative Carr that had asked questions earlier on how can we be so far off with some of our estimates. Really what happens when we're first coming into these kinds of buildings and we have an idea, we can't invest $1.5 million in these kinds of plans without knowing that we're going to get authorization. We just don't have that kind of funding available to us. So it's like if you were going to build a house, excuse me, and you knew how many square feet you needed to, you know, I want four bedrooms and two bathrooms and a living room, dining room, et cetera. And so you have a contractor tell you about how many square feet that would be. And then they use industry averages to tell you about what they would cost. That's what we're doing kind of in the early phases. And then once we get authorization, you come in and you look at the ground that you want to place it on. So we test the soil and you look at maybe the elevations and those kinds of things. And then we go, you know, site by site and say, each floor we're going to do plumbing and electrical and HVAC and those kinds of things. And so that's when we kind of get into the weeds on how much cost is going to be. And that's why it's at that $1.5 million. It's very involved and it's multiple steps, probably a six-month process to get through all of that. So we're at closer to 1.5 than one on the AE and the planning phases for both of those. Long story long.
Thank you. Are there any questions? I guess my one question, if this was chosen, if we change the amendment to that amount, would that allow you to proceed in the time frame that we're waiting for August? Would that help you out? And then if you had overage, you'd come back next year?
Madam Chair, it's obviously not an ideal situation for us, but completely understanding you did the same thing for the health facility earlier today, that it gets us down the road to get, you know, all of the planning and the design and the schematics done, and we can get our arms more clearly around the exact cost for the exact locations for these facilities. And then we would just hope that you have funding available for us next year when we know we're going to still have those cost overruns.
Thank you. Any other questions? Just again, any other questions here? All right, thank you so very much. We are going to recess for 5 minutes. Thank you. Joint Appropriations is coming out of recess. We're going to continue to defer action on 172 till we have some amendments done. And so with that, we are going to go to Senate Bill 33, which amends an appropriation for the revised constructions of the Mineral Industries Building at the School of Mines and Technology and to declare an emergency. We had, yes, I just want to say, we've had the hearing, we had the testimony, and now it's for action or discussion. Senator Johnson.
Madam Chair, thank you. I move to pass Senate Bill 33.
Second.
It's been moved by Senator Johnson, seconded by Senator Colbeck, do pass on Senate Bill 33. Comments on that motion?
Thank you, Madam Chair. So this is the third one now that we've heard about these revised construction costs of projects that we approved last year. The rising costs of this construction have forced the School of Mines to exercise due diligence in minimizing the increase in costs. I just want to make sure that you understand that School of Mines has done due diligence. They've made design changes to their original plan, and they've changed actually the physical site location to mitigate the increase in cost. And I would ask that you support this request on Senate Bill 33.
Thank you. Any further comments on Senate Bill 33? Seeing none, those in favor of the motion of passage of Senate Bill 33 signify by saying aye. Those opposed, nay. Secretary will call the roll.
Representative Otten.
Aye.
Representative Cassin.
Aye.
Representative Mills.
Aye.
Senator Wick.
Aye.
Representative Duba.
Aye.
Senator Foster. Senator Johnson.
Aye.
Representative Kroll.
Aye.
Senator Maher.
Aye.
Representative Carr.
Carr. Yeah, I hear you. Yay.
Representative Koth.
Aye.
Senator Colbeck.
Aye.
Senator Boland.
Aye.
Senator Wink.
Aye.
Representative Van Huysen.
Aye.
Senator Breitling.
Aye.
Representative Derby.
Aye.
Senator Hunoff.
Aye.
18 yea, 0 nay.
By unanimous vote of this committee, Senate Bill 33 is passed. Okay, we'll be at ease here for a few minutes till we get those amendments up.
Amendment for 172. I'm just trying to open it up right now. 172B. Madam Chair, I move amendment 172B.
Second.
It's been moved to amend Senate Bill 172 by Senator Breitling, seconded by Representative Van Huysen. All those in favor of the motion to amend Senate Bill 172 signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay. Motion carried. Senate 172 is amended.
Madam Chair. I move do pass Senate Bill 172 as amended.
Second.
It's been moved by Senator Breitling, seconded by Representative Van Huysen to pass Senate Bill 172 as amended. Comments on that motion?
So the amendment to 172 changed the dollar amount from the $5 million in the original to a general fund sum of $1.5 million to be used for architectural engineering, et cetera, for Black Hill State University. And so this is a compromise to allow this to keep going. We are basically authorizing the Board of Regents to go ahead, get started with architects and engineering. At this dollar figure, we're still waiting for the final approval from the feds, although we feel very confident that it'll be approved. And so this keeps that conversation going, keeps the bill moving along so that we can hopefully continue this construction project later this summer.
Thank you. Any further comments on the amendment and motion? Hearing none, the motion before you is do pass Senate Bill 172 as amended. Those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye. Those opposed, nay. Secretary will call the roll.
Representative Otten.
Aye.
Representative Kasson.
Aye.
Representative Mills.
Aye.
Senator Wick.
Absent, excused.
Representative Duba.
Aye.
Senator Foster.
Aye.
Senator Johnson.
Aye.
Representative Kroll.
Aye.
Senator Maher.
Aye.
Representative Carr.
Aye.
Senator Koth.
Aye.
Senator Colbeck.
Aye.
Senator Boland.
Aye.
Senator Wink.
Aye.
Representative Van Huysen.
Aye.
Senator Breitling.
Aye.
Representative Derby.
Aye.
Senator Hunhoff.
Aye.
17 yea, 1 excused.
By unanimous motion of committee members present, Senate Bill 172 as amended is passed. I think we'll be in recess here for the next one. 173B is not listed yet. Okay, we'll be at recess. We will come out of being at ease and go back in. We are now going to go to Senate Bill 173, which is to increase the appropriation for construction costs related to the new Lincoln Hall at Northern State University and to declare an emergency. Again, this bill has had its hearing and questions, and we are now at action or discussion. Senator Breitling.
Madam Chair, I move Senate Bill Amendment 173B.
It's been moved by Senator Breitling, seconded by Senator Colbeck, to approve 173B amendment. All those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay. The amendment is passed. Senator Breitling.
Madam Chair, I moved Senate Bill 173 as amended.
Seconded.
It's been moved by Senator Breitling, seconded by Senator Boland, to move 173B as amended, or 173 as amended. Comments on that motion?
Madam Chair, very similar to our last discussion at Black Hill State University, Northern and Black Hills are sister facilities. Both are expanding using ARPA dollars. Both of them are using these dollars for nursing program expansion. In addition, Northern is also adding some accounting programs to this as well. We've seen some challenges in Aberdeen with Presentation College announcing their closure. And so what this does, this adds $1.5 million right now for architectural and engineering. When the ARPA projects are approved later this year, then they can move and proceed with that project at that time.
Thank you. Any further comments? Hearing none, the motion is to pass Senate Bill 173 as amended. Those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye. Those opposed, nay. Secretary will call the roll.
Representative Otten.
Aye.
Representative Kasson.
Aye.
Representative Mills.
Aye.
Senator Wick.
Aye. Excuse.
Representative Duba.
Aye.
Senator Foster.
Aye.
Senator Johnson.
Aye.
Representative Kroll.
Aye.
Senator Maher.
No.
Representative Carr.
Aye.
Representative Koth.
Aye.
Senator Colbeck.
Aye.
Senator Boland.
Aye.
Senator Wink.
Aye.
Representative Van Huysen.
Aye.
Senator Breitling.
Aye.
Representative Derby.
Aye.
Senator Hunoff.
Aye.
16 yea, 1 nay, 1 excused.
By majority vote of this committee, Senate Bill 173 as amended is passed. Thank you, folks. Long day. Okay, we start tomorrow again at 8 o'clock.
Madam Chair.
Senate Representative Carr.
I would move that we adjourn.
Second.
It's been moved by Representative Carr, seconded by Senator Colbeck to adjourn. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay. Motion carried. We are adjourned.
Started again.